Have you ever experienced that you almost finish your final project and the deadline is approaching soon? However, the computer suddenly crashed due to the memory problems.
Oh shit, what the?
Today, we are going to talk about a kind of state-of-the-art technology which may have a great impact on our daily life. To avoid this tragedy, what you need is a super memory which is non-volatile, which means your data will be saved even though your power is turned off, and high speed, high density. It turns out we need a new kind of RAM, that is SOT-MRAM. Before we introduce SOT-MRAM, we need to know what RAM is first and how does it work in our computer. The smallest base unit of storage in the computer memory is bit. A bit consists of single binary value, either 0 or 1. Random access memory is a form of computer memory. One of the most popular RAMs is MRAM, magnetoresistive random access memory. Today, we are going to talk about the SOT MRAM. To understand the working principle of MRAM, we have to know its storage element, magnetic tunnel junction first. The MTJ is composed of a fixed magnetic layer, a thin dielectric tunnel barrier, and a free magnetic layer. When the magnetization of free layer and the fixed layer are in the same direction, there are more numbers of polarized electrons can tunnel through the dielectric barrier. And tunneling of the electrons is a kind of quantum effect. So the MTJ device has a low resistance when the magnetic moment of the free layer is parallel to the fixed layer, and a high resistance when the free layer moment is oriented anti-parallel to the fixed layer moment. These are two states of MTJ, and the spin orbital is one of the methods to change magnetization of the free layer. Spin orbital is arising from the spin up coupling of the non-magnetic heavy metals, such as platinum or tantalum. A spin current is composed of spin up and spin down electrons. When we apply an electric current to the non-magnetic heavy metals, the spin up and spin down electrons will turn in different directions. This phenomenon is known as the spin Hall effect. So, we can take advantage of this phenomenon to generate the pure spin current by electric current. And with the assistance of the implant magnetic field, we can switch the magnetization of the free layer from up to down. This magnetic switching can also be done by applying a current pulse in a few picoseconds. Moreover, it requires lower power than STT MRAM. To sum up, with the development of the SOT MRAM, we are able to have an ultra-fast reading and writing speed and lower power consumption. Finally, the computer crash dump is fixed. You don't have to worry about losing your data anymore.
If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like and share to your friends. Thanks for watching.